Which transformations can be used to show that ABCD and EFGH are similar?
Let's look at these rectangles. And according to the way the letters are arranged here, A maps to E, and B maps to F, C maps to G, D maps to H. Now, the only way you could get that type of orientation is a rotation this way. And it would actually be a 90 degrees counterclockwise rotation. So let's see, where does that put us here? If we rotate point A, 90 degrees counterclockwise would be here. Let's call that A prime for now. And point B would rotate to here, B prime. Point C would rotate here, and point D would rotate here. Okay, so let me write that down. 90 degree counterclockwise rotation. Okay, then what would be left as far as doing a transformation here? Well, let me first connect these points. Okay, so it looks like all that's left here is a translation one to the right. That would map this A prime to E, B prime to F, C prime to G, and D prime to H. So then the translation is XY maps to X plus 1 Y. It's just translating one to the right. Okay, now you might have a question, well, what about this 90 degree counterclockwise rotation? Why don't we write that using coordinate notation? And let's do it. XY goes to, and if you're not sure as far as the rotation goes, just take a point or two that you rotated and see what happens. So let's look at point D, for example. D was 1, negative 2. And then D prime became 2, 1. So what happened here is the X and Y value switched, and also the sign changed on one of them. So what happens here is the y value change the sign. So it would be negative y, comma x. So the x and y value switch, the sign of the y changed, and that's how you do the coordinate notation. So these are the two transformations that show the two rectangles are similar. And you can make a stronger statement and say the rectangles are congruent, which would be correct in this case. But the point here is to show the similarity transformations, rotation and translation, and how those work.